Hi there. This is an animated analogy to explain how Beevor Sign occurs. This is the pathological upward movement of the umbilicus on supine neck flexion due to lower rectus abdominis weakness. Beevor Sign is a useful examination finding found in lower thoracic cord lesions and certain myopathies. To understand why Beevor Sign occurs, it is important to know how the rectus abdominis muscle normally contracts, which is typically called the abs muscle. The rectus abdominis is a paired sheet-like anterior abdominal wall muscle. Its main function is to flex the spine. Additionally, it helps hold the abdominal organs in place, and when contracted, allows you to forcefully exhale and evacuate your bowels. This is represented by the two grey cardboards with a gap between them. For analogy purposes, the rectus abdominis is separated into the upper and lower rectus abdominis. In real life, it is a continuing sheet-like muscle with no obvious upper and lower separation. The muscle is supplied by the T6 to T12 nerve roots on either side. The T6 to T9 roots supply the upper rectus abdominis through their corresponding thoracoabdominal nerves. And the T10 to T12 nerve roots supply the lower rectus abdominis via their corresponding nerves. The T6 to T9 root supply to the upper rectus abdominis is represented by the blue handle and ropes connected to the upper grey cardboard. The T10 to T12 root supply to the lower rectus abdominis is represented by the red handle and ropes attached to the lower grey cardboard. The pulleys shown are purely for analogy purposes. The midpoint of the rectus abdominis is the umbilicus, indicated by the green ring. The rectus abdominis originates at the pubis and inserts on the xiphoid process and surrounding ribs centrally. Typically, skeletal muscle contract towards their origin. However, the rectus abdominis is unusual in that because of its multi-bellied structure, the whole muscle contracts as a single unit towards the umbilicus rather than to the pubis. You can test this on yourself by lying down supine and placing your index finger in your belly button. When you lift your head and shoulder blades up as if trying to perform a sit-up, this will contract your upper and lower rectus abdominis together. You should notice that your pubis also elevates because the lower rectus abdominis is pulling it towards the umbilicus. If everything is normal, the whole muscle will contract in unison towards the umbilicus and your finger will stay in place. This is shown in the analogy by the blue and red handles pulling together at the same time, which contracts the upper and lower grey cardboards towards the green ring. On the person, lifting the head up contracts the abs with the pubis also elevating slightly, but the green arrow stays in the same place as rectus abdominis contraction moves towards the umbilicus. When examining patients in real life, ask them to lift their head a few centimeters off the bed and place your hand on their head and apply resistance. This is shown by the weight resistance on the person's head. This will maximally contract the rectus abdominis. It is not possible to voluntarily contract part of the rectus abdominis. It all contracts as one. Rectus abdominis weakness can occur with spinal cord, nerve root, or muscle disorders. Either of these can cause Beevor Sign. Let's imagine a spinal cord lesion at T10, which normally supplies the lower rectus abdominis. As this is a cord lesion at T10, the descending motor neurons going to T11 and T12 will also be involved. If you would like to know more on why this occurs, you can see the spinal cord analogy video in the description. Because of this, a T10 lesion will lead to overall lower rectus abdominis weakness. This is shown in the analogy by the red rope being cut, which signifies that a T10 to T12 root supply to the lower rectus abdominis has been cut. The upper rectus abdominis is not affected, as seen by the intact blue handle and rope. When the patient contracts their rectus abdominis, this leads to a tug-of-war competition between the stronger upper rectus abdominis and the weaker lower rectus abdominis, which ultimately ends up with the umbilicus moving upward in the direction of the stronger upper rectus abdominis. This is shown in the analogy by the green ring moving upward, and on the person, the green arrow moving up. This is known as a positive Beevor Sign. If the lesion occurs at T12, the same positive Beevor Sign will also be seen, as although T10 and T11 can still supply the lower rectus abdominis, it will still be weaker compared to the upper rectus abdominis with no root problems. Let's imagine a different patient with no spinal cord or root issues, but instead they have a problem of the rectus abdominis muscle itself. Certain myopathies, such as myotonic dystrophy, and in particular, facioscapulohumeral muscular dystrophy, preferentially affect the lower rectus abdominal muscles. This means that even though the nerve supply to the lower rectus abdominis is intact, it cannot contract maximally as the lower rectus abdominis muscle itself is weakened. This is represented in the analogy by the lower grey cardboard getting smaller, but its red handle and rope are still intact to show its nerve supply is still present. When this patient contracts their rectus abdominis, there will be a tug-of-war competition between the stronger upper rectus abdominis and the weaker lower rectus abdominis, leading to the umbilicus moving upwards. This is shown in the analogy by the green ring moving upward, and on the person, the green arrow moving up. This is another situation that leads to a positive Beevor sign. Note that Beevor sign only tells you that there is lower rectus abdominis weakness, but not whether it is due to a spinal cord, nerve root, or muscle problem. The rest of the neurological examination will help with this. Less commonly, myopathies may preferentially affect the upper rectus abdominis. This means that when the patient contracts their abs, this time the lower rectus abdominis is stronger than the upper rectus abdominis, and so the umbilicus will move downwards. This is seen by the lower grey cardboard and red handle overpowering the smaller upper grey cardboard and blue handle in a tug-of-war action, which makes the green ring move down. On the person, the green arrow moves down. As this movement is opposite to Beevor sign, it is called the inverted Beevor sign. In summary, checking for Beevor sign is a useful way to confirm lower rectus abdominis weakness due to a cord, root, or muscle pathology at the bedside. Regarding myopathies, it is a highly consistent neurological sign in facioscapulohumeral muscular dystrophy with a sensitivity and specificity of around 95%. Patients with a positive Beevor sign also have absent lower abdominal reflexes, as the lower rectus abdominis is weak. Regarding localization, Beevor sign has better localizing value than abdominal reflex testing. This is because normal individuals may have absent abdominal reflexes, but they should be able to fully contract their rectus abdominis. Lastly, if you suspect the patient has a functional paraplegia, Beevor sign is an excellent test to perform, as it will never be positive on a functional patient, as it is not possible to voluntarily contract part of the rectus abdominis. It all contracts as one.